Hello, and welcome back to Total War Warhammer, the Argwylon on Legendary Difficulty, where this might be the last episode, I'm not sure. There's probably going to be a few battles. Man, I can definitely speak the English language. There's definitely going to be one right now. We're going to attack this army of Aksho. Last time, of course, we triggered the final stage of the Oak of Ages, which means these three armies spawned. I can't remember, is there going to be another battle after that? Yeah, we need to win the defense of the Oak, which I'm guessing is another thing that triggers after that, so that's something to keep in mind too. We finished this lookout, so we should probably build that. I should still keep an eye if I can eventually ally with them, because I probably will need some more amber, because these guys are still attacking them. Attacking my ally dies on several fronts, so we're probably gonna end up losing some. We can afford to lose one, but that's it. But for now, we are currently working on increasing this army, so we're gonna keep doing that. Increasing the size of this army, I should say. And we're recruiting another army here as well, so we're gonna keep building that one up too. And that's actually all of our money spent, interestingly enough. This army is probably gonna run, I'm not sure where exactly, towards the Oak of Ages, probably. We'll see. Or actually, no, it was going to stay around here, because there's this army over here, so we got to sort of wait and see what that one does. This one is going to keep going this way. I could try and assassinate their general. I probably have just about got the money for that. 61%. Make the fight a lot easier. I could try and block this army. That would cost 467. I could cancel one of the units and do that, and do both, I mean. I don't know if blocking this army is really that useful, but it probably is. You can reach easily, right? Ish. Let's move you over here first, and then we'll attack from the back. Assassinated General will be really useful, though. 64%. Alright, he failed. Well, that's unfortunate. We don't have enough money now for this, so I could cancel a unit. I could cancel recruiting a unit somewhere and do that, or just forget about it. You're not doing anything. You might as well do this, too. Well, let's hold off for now, and just attack this guy. Hello. Alright, this probably will be an auto-resolve as well, to be honest, just because auto-resolves are apparently the thing in this campaign, but we'll fight it. Oh god, that is just such an auto-resolve. We're gonna fight it, though. I think this last episode is probably gonna be a little longer, but we're gonna just fight a bunch of battles. Once we've killed all these, well, maybe there'll be one more episode, I'm not entirely sure, but either way, we'll fight a bunch of battles. So they got some Gore Herd, which are crap, some Gore Herd for shields, which aren't particularly great either, some Ungor Raiders, which are crap. Centaurs are great weapons, which I think are okay, but not amazing. Some regular Centaurs, some Razor Gore Herd, and two Minotaurs of shields, which are probably the biggest problem, and of course a general, which would have been nice if we killed him, but we're gonna fight this. Which we're definitely going to lose more men than if I'd auto-resolved it. Man, I really wish the auto-resolve system was different. I know they changed it again recently with the Wood Elves patch, I think, but I don't remember it being this ridiculous. I remember it usually being kind of silly and favorable for the player, making auto-resolves like the better option 90% of the time. I don't remember it being 95% in my favor every single battle, though, with even armies. Like, this is 20 versus 20 units. Like, even if their units were all the lowest tier shit, it still wouldn't be. My guys are pretty low tier. It's just so far in my favor. They got a lovely heal again. This seems to be the fucking common thing, isn't it? Anyway, I'll gamble away at 8. This is not Durthu, this is Dulas. Oh, really? Oh, we lost one. I guess I can't complain too much. Alright, let's just set up. They're probably going to play defensive, but we have massive range advantage, so we'll fire them off that hill. You guys up front, actually. Awaiting orders. I put them on the flanks like this, actually. I've never really done that before, but might as well. Cav. Let's pop two of you in here. Two of you over here. Alright. Let's see what they do. Oh, right. Let's see what they do. They're just gonna sit there. Perfect. I'll gladly take that, because that means they'll probably start coming towards me once we get into their range of firing. And that's perfect, because that means we get to defend a tiny hill. We probably move forward a little bit more, even if we do get into range. Or, yeah, even if we do get into range. You guys are going to stay there for now. I might move you eventually, but what have you got? You've got the Awakening of the Wood, which is that small explosion, and then you've got Potion of Toughness. Okay. Nothing particularly amazing. Razor Gore Herd. They do look really awesome. Not particularly amazing, though, as far as I can remember. Yeah, we're going to have to move forward more anyway, so that's good. Because, like, right here is not really a heal advantage. You want to be fighting around here-ish. Which means possibly running back our archers, but that's okay. Okay, that should probably get us into range, or close enough that they might even get triggered. Not sure. You fake Durthu, keep moving up as well. Okay, not quite in range yet. That's okay. I just want to get into range to trigger them and then run back again, I think. I don't even really want to fire any volleys. You can hear that tree just walking in the background, it's crazy. Alright, I'm assuming they're going to get triggered and, yep, start sprinting like a fucking madman towards me. So let's just get into position right away instead of firing and then running back. Okay, we might want to widen our formation a little bit, actually. Because they're pretty wide, too. They've got a lot of infantry. So they got Centaurus, lots of them on this side. You guys probably want to run into formation, too. Okay, archers, if you can get into formation, that'd be great. Let's fire one of these right here. Boom! Wait, did that just not do anything? I'm not sure. There may have been the error. I don't know what the fuck just happened. Didn't look like it did a whole lot anyway. Have they seen these guys? Yes, they have. Well, I've seen one of them, apparently. That's a lot of stuff to be dealing with two units there. Okay. Over here as well, actually. Let's countercharge them, actually. Otherwise, these guys are going to have to run further and further. Ooh, Minotaur is there. That's not great. I feel like the range units don't find their own targets in this game very well. You need to make sure you target them yourself. You, why don't you go help out with those Minotaurs right there? Okay, they can be distracted as long as they want. That's fine. Oh, you're into three units. That might not be great. Destroying that one, though, so that's okay. You're going to be a while before you get there. We should be winning against the archers really easily. That's something, at least. You aren't firing. Yeah, it's not great. But luckily, these guys are anti-Minotaurs, technically, so that's good. Okay, what's going on over here? Could they charge into me? We're fighting one Razor Gore Herd with our Treekin. Probably an okay fight. You guys, fire at them. You guys, try and run around the flank here. They're just going to sit there. I'll take that. Actually, no, you can fire at them. You fire at them. A nice flanking shot on them. They are running away from us. Try and make sure they don't actually get away. Oh yeah, they can fire all running. I forgot about that. Alright, I want you over here, though. Where is their general? I didn't think about that. Maybe should have sent him into the general. Oh, he got caught here anyway. Use another one of these. Get over here. Are we winning? Looks like we're okay for now. You guys get over here. I actually just didn't realize we have units standing idle right there. Okay. Your lord is under attack. Well, I think he's okay. Alright, you're still chasing stuff. You guys have essentially killed everything off. Are you firing? Yep, you're firing. Alright, perfect. You guys are going to have to come over here again. You fire at that unit. I think we're about to win this. Definitely took a lot more losses than we would have if we had fought it ourselves. Or if we auto resulted even. We are fighting it ourselves. Victory's in our grasp. Good. Alright, these archers. I'm going to start running you up this... No, we're not. There's this general still over here. Oh, he's in melee with one of my range units. Fucking other units dead. Okay, general. Come over here. Is there a Minotaur unit in here as well? Doesn't look like it. Okay, we won. It was pretty painful. But we won. And this was the easiest of the fights as well. I should actually get some of my cav over here. Right, you four are just going to run this way and fire while running that way. You guys are going to run over there. If we could kill some of our units, that'd be great. So definitely don't... Oh, I completely forgot to actually send them after something as well. That's a raid. No, they're going to get away. Razor Gore Herd. You, like, try. Yeah, keep chasing that general. Might be able to kill him off. Have we got anything? I haven't got anything over here. You guys are gonna... Yeah, you're gonna kill that unit off. I don't think you guys are gonna be able to get back here, but try it anyway. The way that guy's running, we might do. 3 out of 60, they're probably dead. Let's get him over here. Might as well get the healing up a little bit. Ah, I forgot to actually keep you guys running. Oh. Some impassable terrain there that I clicked on. I don't know, I must be doing a lot of friendly fire as well here, to be fair. 47, pretty sure they had more men before. You guys fire at them. You guys fire at them. 45 now, yeah, we're definitely losing men. You kill them. Perfect. Might be able to get a slap off of him. Nope, something just happened to him. I wonder what that was. I want to try this. Might be too far ahead of him. That looked pretty good. I almost hit my own guys, I'm pretty sure. Well, we knocked him down. And we got a slap or two of him. They're going to get a new general, but it's pretty worth it. Because we might be able to finish them off right away. Oh, he's taking fucking damage now. Kill off some more units. I think most of their army probably is dead anyway.
Ready and able.
Come on, kill this man. I know you can do it. Oh, the Treekin are almost there. They want a piece of him as well. See, this is what I love. Well, I don't actually like this very much at all. But this is what's interesting about this game. This guy lost about a third of HP, but didn't lose a single man. So at the end of the battle, it's gonna be full health again. I don't know. The mechanic is okay because it's just, you know, that's how health works. Again, like if you're not dead, you're not dead. But it's just kind of weird the way it like happens after this. Like this unit's just gonna be full health. It's not gonna be wounded or anything. It's gonna be full health. Can we kill this guy already? There we go. You're still chasing stuff off. Oh, they just went off. How much fucking HP has this guy got? We're slapping him with the general as well. You'd think he'd be... Oh, there you go. I was gonna say, you'd think he'd be pretty strong, but... Alright. That was an okay battle. The auto resolve definitely would have been better, but... I mean, we only lost 307 men, to be fair. But it's just like one or two units... Well, three units that are really weak. Yeah, that's actually just it. It's just three units that are weak. That's about it. I think they probably had five, maybe six units survive there. So that's okay. And hopefully we can finish them off, but I'm not sure if we'll be able to. And the problem is also is that if we do, that other army in the south could come reach us. Get some of that money. They're dead, 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 dead. Yeah, these two survived, and then these two as well, and that one. So five units survived. Alright, cool. Got a banner. Fire damage around self. Can we give that to you? Because you're usually in the mix of things as well anyway, so. Right, if we attack this army again, if we can even reach. Yeah, we can reach. And obviously this one is like easily in range. Maybe, well, he's not really. Oh, he's just. He's a Beastman ambush. Oh yeah, that's his normal stance, isn't it? Okay, so we might be able to like just run out of his range, or get into Canal, which is probably the safer option. Yeah, we didn't really lose that much, to be honest. If we have to defend that town, that'd be fine, because the five garrison units will make up for the men we lost so far, which really aren't that many, looking at it now. We will be tired, though, if we run into Canal. That's the only problem here. Camera. I'll still do it, though. Makes sense. Even if we're tired. And you. You never got this. Well, it's about time you get that then. Especially now. Right, this army. Where would he logically go is the real question. What's our ambush chance here? 65%. Can we set up? We can, but not enough movement. He might run towards us or something now. I don't want to go too far down there, because if he decides to go some other way entirely, we want to make sure we can get down here fastish. So let's just move up. Let's move into Montfall. I think that's fine. Alright, so you're recruiting six more units. You're recruiting three more units. I mean, next turn I might just run this army into the Oak of Ages just to make sure. If they... Depends on what this army does, really. I also don't know. Maybe they're going to keep spawning. Like, what if they spawn three new armies every turn? Nah, that'd be insane, right? Oh, we got a lot of money, so I can actually try and blockade this army anyway. Or block this army and I'll blockade it. Success. Alright, so if he decides to move this way, he can't get very far. He can only barely get to Canal, so that may have actually made him attack that town instead. Which I guess I'll be okay with. Fuck it. I really don't care. You're not going to go in an army. Okay, so that's all of our money spent. Can upgrade this, but that's shit. Alright. I don't want to recruit any more armies. I think four is plenty. Victories. The only problem we still have is the fact that we're probably going to lose more amber. And there's no way we can get any back. I'm glad I went out of my way to kill that Malagor army there over there, by the way. That would have been another one we had to deal with. I'm a dwarf of the Artois as well now. I forgot about that. We may have to leave Durthu's army up here the entire time to defend against them as well. But with all the stuff being made, we should be fine either way. Maybe we should have made a tweak in here first, actually. But oh, I could still do that, actually. Yeah, let's do that. I'm almost half tempted to recruit some other archers just to get some variety as well, but those units are just too shit. Are there any other... I could get a Great Eagle or something. I might recruit a Great Eagle, just so we have used the Great Eagle in the campaign. Maybe some Hulk Riders, even though they're fucking disgustingly terrible. Although I've actually been told they're really good as melee cavalry. You just, like, you kill archers with them. But it's like... I mean, I understand that, and that, I'm sure that's a good use for them. But it kind of defeats the purpose of their whole... Like, their ranged flying cav, you know? Like, that's their whole thing. Like, if I wanted to use that type of... If I wanted to use a unit that flies, but I can send it to the floor and then attack in archers, I would have played as a Bretonian. Well, obviously the campaign isn't available yet, but there is a mod. I would have played as a Bretonians and used that Pegasus Knight unit or whatever, these ones. Because they're made for that. That's what they do. This is their whole thing. These Hulk Riders are archers with the added bonus that they can charge into infantry as well. But then again, some people say the archery is a bonus and like you should use them as melee cav, but whatever. Doesn't really matter. I am not really planning on using them for realsies. Their army just stayed there. That's not great. I would have preferred they actually went somewhere, because I can't really leave this now. Oh shit, there's a massive scale. Oh shit, there's a lot of scaling armies. Okay, I may have to keep this army here just for more reasons than that. The Will of the Forest defeats that one. Okay. We're not at war with... Oh shit, no. Okay, hold on. I don't think this is true, but these armies aren't... No, they're not. I was gonna say, these armies didn't spawn in to come after the Oak of Ages as well, right? Because that would become pretty crazy if that was all, like, everything together. But no, that doesn't seem to be the case. If we go here... I don't think we can get back. That's kind of unfortunate. Let's go over here. Yeah. I want to get these guys in there so we got them available. And I guess these ones too. No, it's okay. I thought I just accidentally cancelled all my global recruitment, but I didn't. Yep. Alright, so this army's almost full now. We're gonna recruit two more cav. I think I recruited... No, I didn't. No, this is fine. Yeah, it's done. It's done next turn. Nice. Alright, so you're gonna go back into you're not gonna go back into Waterfront Palace, or are you? Yeah, you are. And you're gonna recruit another army. You're also gonna do some global recruitments. Might as well do the cav. No, there's no reason to do that. These guys. Makes more sense. Alright, so this army's full next turn. We're just going to pop it in Oak of Ages and it'll be fine. This army I can attack them with, but I don't really think that's worth it. What I might do is I might actually try to kill their general here. He's got a lower chance now because we failed. Damn it. That's kind of unfortunate. That's pointless. Let's get that. Okay, I was kind of hoping to assassinate the general so I could just walk in and kill him with this army, but I guess I won't. I'll just keep sitting here though. I'm not gonna let them. Like, if they do decide to go down this way, I follow them. It doesn't really matter. Alright. We're down to 1900 income, about 2k. Really want to attack them, but then we have to deal with so much more and they could fuck everything up for me. We're definitely going to lose 2 amber, which is one too many, which is really unfortunate. But there's no way we can get any more easily right now. Well, actually, there is one way. Yeah, okay, we got a little bit of money. We could just use this army. It's pretty dangerous, but... Nah. I think the only downside of having lower than or less than 0 amber is reduced replenishment rate, which is annoying, but not that big a deal. It gets really worse from minus 10 or minus 11 onwards or something, and I'm not really planning on getting that low. Anyway, because I was thinking I could recruit one general and just put him in, like take that town, but we can't really do that because we haven't got the money for one general to do that. And we need to recruit more units as well. Nope, no technologies. It's unfortunate that one amber is going to make the difference after all this time, but what are you going to do? Oh, I can still possibly ally with the Clan Angren as well if they eventually become a little more inclined. Oh, hello. Oh, they want peace. Perfect. Hey, why don't you become my vassal or something? I can't ally with them because they're more of my ally. Sure. One less worry. I don't like the whole chaos being over there, though, but... Again, it doesn't really make any difference in the grand scheme of things, because in however many turns it is, we have to defend it against the oak, whatever the fuck it's called, thing. Oh, shit, another one just spawned, okay. Well, that changes things. Do they just spawn indefinitely? They spawn up to 3 armies, so you kill one, another one spawns. If that's the case, I just want to block their army movement the entire time. I think I might jump this guy over here. And just in case. Because I can jump him back into the Oak of Ages or close to next turn anyway. Yeah, let's see if that's a good idea. Just so I've got another army here as well, in case they do want to go for something. But I think I try to keep blocking them. Maybe I do try to assassinate the generals. No, I'll do that next turn. Come on. Alright, we got one. That's good. Because either that splits them up or they stay there. Or they move partially, but that's good enough. That one, sure. Income is definitely going down. So they've still got that one, but it's getting more and more wounded. So chaos being here, it's definitely a little scary. Fucking hell, these chaos armies. Not a particularly good army, but... They're at war with Border Princes, Bretonnia, and Dwarfs, so... Not sure who they're going after, but probably Border Princes or Dwarfs. Let's hope that's the case. But again, in 7 turns... Yeah, 7 turns, then we have to battle. We just win, no matter what. So, it's all fine. You are gonna get something. Maybe should have gotten that actually. Yeah, because I'm recruiting units here, it makes sense. Alright, more Glade Guards. And that's all I can do. Alright, so next turn I'll try and assassinate the generals and then we just kill them or something. This army is gonna just keep sitting here for now. This guy is taking more and more attrition. I don't know if it's attrition. I mean, it's just these agents fucking this army up the entire time. Either way, whatever it is, fine by me. it makes it so that that army is getting weaker and weaker and less of a problem for me. So it's all good. And I'm getting stronger and stronger, so it's less likely people will declare war on me because of that. Ah, they move partially. Perfect. So we should be able to finish both of those armies off right now. The way we've seen it right now is that even when we've got a massive advantage, they still don't run away. So we might be able to just like move both armies over, kill them, move over to the next one, kill them, and done. And even if I can't, a single army probably would be enough to auto-resolve it. Let's find out. The thing is, though, even if we do, it looks like they're just gonna like get new armies back. Alright, let's move you right here. And we attack with you. Maybe I should try and assassinate a general anyway. Or block the army so they can't move very far. Yeah, let's go for that. Nice, okay. Leveled up again. That's some great leveling here. I don't want to... Oh, actually, we can... No, that's pointless. There might be something else there that's good, but I don't give a shit. Okay, they did run away, but they only moved like 2 feet, so that's good enough. Okay. You're in range right there, but that's... I'm still going to move you. Because he's got more movement overall. Alright, so that's like the easiest out of us all, plus the army will disappear. Plus we're going to get a bunch of money, which is actually kind of useful right now. Oh, wait, he's not in range. Okay. Do I want to just do it anyway? Yeah, fuck it. Yeah, we lost 102 men. They survived, but they're still dead, because they moved away already. We can still reach that one, too. And this is why I didn't want to use that guy's movement too much, because now we can just use this one for that. He's going to run away. Oh, shit, I didn't actually sabotage him. That's fine. We can run into his range. Yes, that should be fine. Good enough. And again, one army would have been enough anyway. If only you got Amber for like these ridiculous amount of battles we're fighting. 140. We lost more men that fight than we did in the previous one, and we had two armies in this one. Oh well. Okay, so it seems to give us at least one turn before those armies respawn, I think. So I think they're going to come back in 2 turns. Which is good. You're gonna go for that melee. Ara, you need to still go for all this shit. Your army's really crap actually because of that. Where can you run to? Not quite anywhere, so no reason to run you anywhere. You can stay here so you're in reinforcement range in case there is several army pop-ups. You can stay around here. You can sit in there. You're recruiting nothing, so let's get that done. Oh god, our income. Okay. So our income is actually at the point where it's pretty crap now. I don't think we necessarily need that many more units either. Let's recruit a bunch of shit units still. Just a bunch of these guys, and then that's good. I mean, we have 3 full stacks. I mean, this guy doesn't have the experience yet, but still. 3 full stacks plus... another half a stack essentially, and that's with just slightly going below zero income. We're gonna be like minus 250 or something. That's good enough. All those agents that rank ups we just got for getting extra money or something probably would be enough to put them in the town in these towns, but I need them on the field. So anyway, we end another turn. I think that's gonna be the end of the episode as well. I reckon we could literally put like all of our armies at the Oak of Ages and just that would just be it. That'd be fine. I don't know how the Defense of the Ages, Defense of the Oak battle, whatever it's called, is gonna happen. Okay, they're moving away again, that's good. Don't really care about their raiding, just the fact that they could possibly attack me and be annoying, but again, not the end of the world. Raiding. Trollio's ready. And Durthu get ranked up from just sitting there. Nice one. Minus 331, okay. Right, anyway, that's going to be where I end the episode. So it's gonna be another episode. I mean, I could make this one slightly longer, but it looks like there might be another fight or two, plus there's 5 more turns, and the Defense of the Oak Ages, so it'll be a long episode if I did that. Though. So I'll end it here. I'm possibly going to chase this army down, actually. But then again, it's just sitting there. It's not doing anything. If they have new armies respawning, I'd rather have this one just sit there indefinitely, right? So we'll see. It'll be next time, though. So until then, have a good day and goodbye.